Don't worry about the name on the front of the jersey. It's about us. It's play our game. And folks, we're underway from Maples Pavilion. Stanford winning the opening tip in the white uniform. Montana State coming in out of the Big Sky, and they force a turnover on Stanford's first possession as we take a look at tonight's starting lineups brought to you by Capital One. Cola Bad Bear, Caitlin Lombardo, get to know those names, but Darian White is the engine that powers this train for Montana State as Cameron Brink on the bucket and getting the Cardinal on the board first. And tough inside with the trees as Stanford running the floor, and Brink once again, thanks to an assist from Anna Wilson. Haley Jones, you talked about her, and the Hull twins in the open. It's all five players who just make this Stanford team and program the powerhouse that they are. Bad Bear on the rebound, finding Gabby Maki, the lone senior in the starting lineup for the Bobcats.
Montana State has to be careful about quick shots because you see how quickly Stanford turns that rebound into points offensively.
It stays with the Bobcats coming in at 22-12 on the season. They were able to capture the Big Sky Tournament Championship, their third conference tournament title in program history. Darian White, obviously, we mentioned a big part of that. Agent Zero in blue for the Bobcats. And just out of the outstretched hands of Cola Bad Bear. The legendary, the Hall of Famer, Tara Vanderveer, and watching her Stanford team continuing to feed Cameron Brink, the sophomore standout. And there's Coach Vanderveer in the 36th season at the helm of this program. All-time winningest coach in women's basketball history. You see the numbers there, 1,153 wins. And Cameron Brink, who's definitely excited to play in an NCAA tournament, trying to again march their way back to another title. It's a big deal right now as Cameron Brink is responsible for all 5 points for the Cardinal.
Well, there's not going to be an answer for Montana State to guard Cameron Brink. It's going to be collective defense.
Off the steal, Lexi Hall can't finish it at the rim, but to your point, go ahead, finish.
Well, something to remind folks at home, this is Stanford, some of the younger players, Cameron Brink, Haley Jones, their first opportunity to host the first two rounds of the NCAA tournament. No doubt, they're hyped to start this game.
You think so? I think the Hall sisters are as well, as that's Lexi, one of the twins on this team, getting on the board, averaging just about 12 points a game, and she's that player who is one of those difference makers because she's part of that engine that drives this group. How about Cameron Brink on the block? We asked about the wingspan of Cameron Brink, and I think we can only just assume it's pretty wide ranging.
I mean, she's...
Lacey Hall with the context lens issue, but let's go back to Brink's block.
Yeah, 2.5 blocks a game from Cameron Brink on the season, a 6'4 sophomore.
Pac-12 Defensive Player of the Year, third team All-American is Brink out of Beaverton, Oregon.
Well, she's averaging a block a minute right now.
and points, too. I mean, she's registered 5 of the 7 for Stanford.
Well, a lot of people talk about Haley Jones and Stanford, and rightfully so, but Tara Vanderveer told us Cameron Brink has been the go-to player this season for them.
And picking up the personal foul is Gabby Maki. She fouls Brink, and here's a good look, bio blast on her. We mentioned some of her accolades and accomplishments, but she's just so tough to defend, soft hands, And she's a player that they brought along slowly when she came into the program, and then she was like, nah, I'm just going to take off.
And has she?
Darian White out to Maki. And Hull skying for that rebound. Lexi Hull, senior out of Spokane, Washington.
Good defensive play by the Bobcats. Look, we listened to Trisha Benford in the huddle or to start the game. It's about us. It's about belief. In a 116 type of matchup, you've got to believe on every play, because as a one seed, they're sensing any sort of vulnerability and they pounce. So as Montana State, you're the underdog. You don't have to play. Leave it all out there.
Jump ball as White was tied up with Brink, and it stays with the Bobcats, who are making their third ever NCAA tournament appearance, the last one coming in 2017. They ran into another Pac-12 opponent in Washington, and Kelsey Plum and all of her exploits, as she was the nation's leading scorer and league player of the year at the time. Try to get it inside. And again, a fall to the floor, jump ball. And it's Stanford basketball. We talked about just what this means to be able to play in front of your home crowd, to be able to truly have a tournament at home for several of these players, especially that sophomore class you mentioned, as Hull with the reverse layup. And the fans inside Maples Pavilion are appreciating the start to this ball game.
When you look at how all the number one seeds performed today, South Carolina, what they were able to do to start this game.
Ooh, wait a minute, did you see that whip by Wilson? Number one seeds showing out right now as...
Tell them, Tiff.
Montana State calls a timeout. But Anna Wilson has brother Russell Wilson standing tall. Whip it, real hard. Anna Wilson finding Fran Belibi for the bucket. Welcome back to the NCAA Women's Championship presented by Capital One. An 11-0 lead to start this ball game for Stanford, and we saw the new Denver Bronco in the building. That's Russell Wilson, older brother to Anna.
I always love seeing big bro support and little sis. And Anna Wilson has just been such a veteran player for Tara Vanderveer, a captain for the Stanford Cardinal team, so much so that she was the captain when Haley Jones was a freshman. Haley Jones now a junior captain with Anna Wilson.
Some contact, believe me. Gets up and she'll go to the line and shoot a couple. Yeah, Belibi remembers when Anna Wilson was a senior. She's a super senior on this team. Took an extra year of eligibility. Her sixth year here at Stanford out of Seattle, Washington. Watch her, because not only does she make great passes, but also a lockdown defender.
Terrific defender, great leader, just does a lot of the little things to steady the ship. If you talk to Tara Vanderveer, three important pieces to this puzzle have been the Hull sisters, Lexi and Lacey, and Anna Wilson.
Steal there from the Bobcats, the crossover, Ava Ranson, who checks in, air mails it. Wilson pushing the tempo and just out throws a racing Hull. 4:41 remaining in the first quarter. It's all Stanford. Women's Championship is presented by Capital One. What's in your wallet? and in part by the Walt Disney World Resort 50th anniversary celebration. And going back to that glorious moment for the Cardinal as they were able to inch out their Pac-12 foe Arizona 54-53. And talk about Haley Jones and the terrific tournament she had.
Here's what I love about Haley Jones. She's Cali cool. On to the next play. She's got a lot of hobbies. She loves life outside of basketball. She's got balance to her. If you watch her play, she's having fun. You know, when Aaliyah Boston missed that shot and immediately started crying, Haley Jones said, "The game is over. I'm Haley Jones. I'm Aaliyah Boston's best friend." That's why she ran over and hugged her. "I'm on to the next play. If the game's over, the game is over." She moves on. She's just got a coolness about her that I think really carries over onto the team. They've got this grittiness, but they move on. They don't hold their heads. I just like that, Tiff.
I appreciate that,
you
too.
You know what I mean?
But, like, as a player, like, at some point, too, you've got to think that, like, being, like, the most outstanding player in last year's NCAA tournament would stand out to you, or being the Pac-12 player of the year means a little something, too.
Having the mayor give you the key to the city.
Yeah.
I think she said cool beans. I know someone who uses that reference.
My kind of gal. Cool beans is a really good, simple response and answer. Try it via text message. It works for you all the time. The block by Belibi. Leading the break. Hall, who continues to just find her way, running in transition. And then Belibi is fouled. How many times have we seen Lexi Hull come up near the right side or close to us on the break?
Well, Stanford is just so fast offensively, but Hull, she's so underrated, Tiffany. In my opinion, I think she's one of the most underrated players nationally. She defends. It's hard to find another player that plays harder than her every possession. I think I said we were talking to Tara Vanderveer about it. She's got the second most offensive rebounds on the team, only nine less than Cameron Brink.
That's impressive. Although she's got some good size, 6'1", that's one of the things that Trisha Benford was concerned with, their size. Just not a lot of weaknesses with this ball club. And she said, okay, that's no problem. We're just gonna find a way, though, to try to put up points. That was the most important piece of it, try to put up points. And right now, they're still searching for their first bucket.
See what Montana State really does well is they get to the free throw line, the top 10 team in free throws attempts. But what's happening in this game so far is the length of Stanford totally disrupting their ability to draw fouls.
Believe he kicks it over to Haley Jones. And he nearly loses it. Still able to get up a shot. Believe he with the O board and then hounded by a few Bobcats, traveling violation.
Cameron Brink gets the Cardinal.
Jones checks out, Brink back on the floor.
Because of Stanford's length and quickness along the perimeter, Tiffany, Montana State's gonna have to pass fake, shot fake, really rely on the fundamentals to try to catch Stanford off guard, make their defense really rotate over, work for 30 seconds.
An extra pass over to Leah Beatty, and Beatty off the mark. Gotta think about this Montana State group who had one of the youngest teams last season. They return many of those players again, and Coach Benford talked about the way the sophomore class has really stepped up and made some big plays for them this season, but playing in, you know, their first NCAA tournament. Nice dish once more from Wilson to Belibi. And Anna Wilson is making her presence felt on the offensive end, facilitating remember, they lost Kiana Williams last year, who was a big piece. She ran the show for the Cardinal. And so Tara Vanderveer talked about the way they kind of had point guard by committee. A shot off the mark there from Hannah Jump. But Wilson can handle the ball. Haley Jones has done that, along with Lacey Hull.
Yeah, Lacey Hull wanted to get on the floor. I mean, she's had four different roles in four different years. This year, she wanted to get out on the floor, play some minutes, and that was going to be at the point guard position. She stepped up to the plate.
But that was something that wasn't necessarily foreign to this Bobcats team. Because as Coach Binford told us, you know, they faced a number of opponents who had that versatility in their guard play in conference. Well, Darian White, the junior out of Boise, Idaho, they've got to find a way to get her going. She was the Big Sky Tournament most outstanding player as the Bobcats defeated Northern Arizona 75-64. And pushed out of bounds by Lombardo. When you watch this Stanford offense, you see that they never stop moving. Tough entry pass with defenders at her front and back, but Cameron Brink says, I don't pay that, no, never mind.
It's the angle of the passes that Stanford really separates themselves offensively, where the guards enter the ball to the post players, where Cameron Brink doesn't have to dribble, she can go right up with it. Hitting shooters in transition in stride. It's the little things like that that go a long way.
They force it inside. Ooh. Again, and a hard foul as Cameron Brink and Lombardo collided. Lombardo went over to try to help Brink up, so good sportsmanship there. As Brink is assisted up by our teammates.
Yeah, both the players took a shot there, and Caitlin Lombardo, I mean, talking to Trisha Benford about prepping for this NCAA tournament, they wanted to go maybe not a lot of contact, but Caitlin Lombardo got a little bit too close, right up in someone's face, took a shot to her nose, has to wear the mask.
I think by all indications, she broke her nose.
Yeah, she did.
Yeah. Lombardo goes inside. Maki. And Anna Wilson slows up as Stanford, who shot 8 of 15 in this first quarter, 53% from the floor. And Hannah Jump misses there. So far, the top seed Stanford putting on a clinic after one quarter. They're up 8. Steffi Sorensen, Tiffany Green, back here with you from Maples Pavilion. An impressive start to this ball game as Stanford, just the second team in NCAA tournament history to hold a team scoreless in a quarter. Last season, South Carolina was able to do it to Texas.
Earlier today, watching South Carolina and the way that they started that game against Howard, you looked at that score, you go, wow. That's an emphatic statement from Don Staley's ball club. You think Stanford was watching that game? 20-0 in the first quarter? I mean, just the total finesse offensively, but defensively, getting it done as well.
Cameron Brink is being hounded right there by Lexi Deedon, and it'll stay with the Cardinal. And you referenced this earlier, Steffi, about the dominance of the one seed. Three of the four top seeds were in action today.
Yeah, Louisville taking care of business. And a jump. Getting in there for three. Haley Van Lith for Louisville, 20 points. Emily Engsler, 17. For a reminder of folks at home, if you haven't seen Emily Engsler, if you get lost in the woods, you call Emily Engsler because she can get you out.
That was one of my favorite references on the season, as Taylor Jansen helping the Bobcats to get on the board. And the cut to the basket as Lexi Hull registers two more.
What makes Stanford so good offensively too, Tiffany, is they don't waste a lot of dribbles. It's cuts, pass, cut, pass. Very difficult to defend because, you know, someone's over dribbling, it's pretty easy to defend.
They kick it back out to the perimeter. Lombardo finds Deedon. The shot clock expires. We talk about their offensive balance, but also their defense. Holding opponents to about 57 points per game. And that's where ultimately it starts. If you want to win championships, you've always heard defense wins championships, but certainly when you add the offensive finesse that Stanford brings to the court, they get some style points from me. Well, one of the things that we have noticed is that the Bobcats have forced six turnovers for Stanford in about the first 12 minutes.
Really want to see Darian White, the 5'6 junior, get going offensively. She's been the heart and soul of this Bobcat team, and right on cue, they go as she goes.
It starts and ends with White.
Terrific around the rim. Cameron Brink goes to the bench. Darian White goes to the rim.
Unanimous first team all Big Sky selection. And how about the scoring picking up here for the Bobcats in the second quarter? Four of the six coming from Taylor Jansen. Ashton Prechtold checked in. Again, that cut, that's going to be there all game long.
As a defender, you never want an offensive player to cut across your face. You want to jump to the ball. It's an adjustment Montana State has to make. Been too easy so far for Stanford.
The kick out, Deedon. Finds Ava Ranson. And Ranson saying that was deflected by Prechtold, who was in her face.
I'm going to watch Lexi Hull moving without the basketball. Fakes out the defender, cuts right to the basket. Stanford, 9 assists on 11 made field goals. No dribble necessary. You're moving and cutting. It's all about making reads.
We see the numbers for Stanford on the season offensively, sharing the ball really well. Tops in threes and field goal percentage. Jansen able to sit the fans down momentarily inside Maples as Hannah Jump with her second three. You know, one of the cool things that Tara Vanderveer pledged to do before the start of the tournament is donate $10 for every made three to help with Ukrainian relief. She and Georgia Tech head coach Nell Fortner teamed up along with some other coaches.
Yeah, it's really starting to take over the NCAA tournament. It's just such a Tara Vanderveer thing to do. It's bigger than basketball for her.
Believe one hand rebound. And the foul. And all right, give Fran Belibi her flowers. I think this is a top 10 nominee. Belibi says, I used to do this back on the playground, but now all I do is win, throw it down. Belibi says, you better believe me, I'm legit. Let's take a look at how Fran Belibi is achieving the impossible, brought to you by Adidas.
Fran Belibi in transition. This is something everybody in the stands wanted to see. Why she does this on the regular. I got two words for people who don't want to see this in the game. Hi, haters.
And remember, it was in her freshman season or sometime back in December 13th of 2020 that she was the first woman to dunk in a college basketball game, women's basketball game, since Brittany Griner did it back in 2013. But third career dunk for Belibi. And a shot clock violation.
I'm just tired of the haters, Tim.
You're tired of Hi, haters.
This is becoming
a part of
this is becoming a part of the women's game. It just is.
She won a slam dunk contest, and if she has the hops to do it, why would you turn that down?
I'm not getting on my soapbox tonight.
Okay, well,
don't get me on the soapbox.
Look, you know, you have nothing but space and opportunity right now.
First person on number 44, Kiki Uriyaka, first team foul.
But that's the difference. I want to go back to a point you mentioned just about playing in front of fans. Last year they didn't have this. You know, you went to a neutral site. They rotated gymnasiums. We were calling it from home. The feel of being back in the arena is special. And that's the kind of reaction. That's how you feed off of the sixth man. Is after a play like that, everyone just lost their mind inside of here.
You saw me stand up?
Yes, you did. Applaud as Leah Beattie with the bucket and stole it away. All right, watch out for the Bobcats to miss. I tell you, sometimes it just takes a moment to kind of settle in. The shock, the bright lights.
No doubt. And it was a concern for Trisha Benford about playing in this arena, mm-hmm. knowing that it was going to be packed in an exciting environment. Good defense from Bad Bear. Just keeping her hands up, being active, trying to disrupt some of Stanford's offense. They're so rhythm-based, their cadence and how they cut and pass. If you keep your hands up, you're moving your feet, you can disrupt that a little bit. We saw that at possession for Montana State.
What does Tara Vanderveer always reference? The orchestra. She's the conductor. Is this one stolen away by Lacey Hull? And Hull, as you talked about, taking over as the point guard, unafraid to step into that role, unafraid to step into that shot, was Haley Jones. As Kiki Iriafin with the over-the-back call coming up at halftime. Degree in the studio. This is what's coming your way. We referenced how South Carolina took care of business in dominating fashion in their first round game. Baylor rolling on as well. And it's been a fun day of basketball and a tournament both on the men's and women's side with upsets early on. Although I don't know if you were surprised by the South Dakota win over Virginia Tech or Florida Gulf Coast.
Both teams with experience, and experience matters in March. We've seen it on the men's side. Some of the younger teams versus veteran teams. How about the floater for Darian White? Trisha Benford went on and on about her ability once she gets in the paint to knock it down.
Cola Bad Bear guarding Haley Jones, and she skirts her way around. Jones's first 2 points of the night. Stolen away once more. Five steals on the night for the Cardinal. Deep three from Haley Jones, making it look easy. And timeout taken by the Bobcats. Jumps third triple of the night.
Hannah Jump just continues to improve her game now as a junior. This is her bread and butter. 3-point shooting, so good. Freshman year, she hits 43 threes in just 10 minutes, as that was her average. Tiffany, sophomore year, she's averaging 16 minutes. She hits 57. Junior year, she's averaging 24 minutes. Coming into this game, she had 73.
Well, the NCAA Women's Basketball Championship across the ESPN family of networks, from the Sweet 16 to taking you all the way to the championship game, April 3rd on ESPN in Minneapolis at 8 Eastern. You can also find the games on the ESPN app. So Coach Vanderveer already out of pocket, $30. So those $10 for every made three in the tournament. You know, the Utes had
Utah,
15.
MGCU.
Yeah, they had 14. Oh, yeah.
What did Tara come over and say to us at the break? She said, man, that GCU is going to cost me a lot of money.
There were 778 threes made in last year's tournament, so we'll see what this year's tournament registers out to be. The top seed in the Spokane region. And that one rims out, but Jump will get another chance. And lots of opportunities around the basket, but a lid there on that possession. So Cameron Brink will go to the line after Taylor Jansen commits the foul.
And Colo Badger in for the Bobcats. Fran Bellini in for the Cardinal. Cameron Brink at the line shooting two.
Brink's night already prior to the two shots. 7 points, seven rebounds, and she's adding to that total right now.
Stars have been shining already on this first day of the tournament. We saw Caitlin Clark do her thing. Leah Boston, another double-double. Cameron Brink, first half, almost has a double-double. As I mentioned, Kirsten Bell in our previous game, a problem. Have to mention Liz Kitley and what she did.
Oh, my goodness.
Over 40 points for Virginia Tech. Unbelievable performance. Mm-hmm.
Joanna Wilson, who's dropped off a few dimes. And they find Hannah Jump again. Can't connect. Ripped away by Deaton. And Montana State looking to hold for the final shot of the half. Now off the leg of White, so now Stanford will have their opportunity. Wilson pushing it up the court, heaves it up at the buzzer. Won't go. Beliebe leading the way for the Cardinal with 11 points, but certainly she got two of those points via big style as she comes away with the block. And then what does she do? She said, I'm gonna finish it on the other end. What else you want me to do? Come on. This is what we play for, ladies and gentlemen. Let's go over to the studio with Kelsey, Monica, and Drea for the halftime report. Who has 11 points to lead all scorers, has had the play of the tournament so far. Haley Jones. And there's Wilson in the corner for three. Looking back over to the bench, and maybe she looked over to her brother as well. Said, you see that, bro?
I can make news too.
Lombardo tried to get it back over to Bad Bear, and it was kicked out of bounds.
Right on cue, Stanford sharing the basketball, but the wraparound pass to find Wilson for the three. Stanford can hit you inside, they can hurt you outside. Russell Wilson, he can throw it deep, he can run it and pick up a first down. Runs in the family.
For sure, Wilson thought about another one instead. Creates an opportunity for Hull, who sees it rim in and out. And Cameron Brink, with a big smile on her face underneath after that offensive rebound, finds Haley Jones. This is a Stanford team making their 34th consecutive appearance in the NCAA tournament. Third for Montana State as that one rolls around the bucket from Cola Bad Bear.
She had such a good Big Sky tournament, averaging 17, but a tough matchup for her against Cameron Brink.
Second personal, number 10, Cola Bad Bear.
Again, the Cardinal moving without the basketball, getting right into the paint, dropping it off to one of their bigs. So unselfish.
Think about a player like Cola Bad Bear. You talked about she had a great tournament. They try to get it into her again, but she's just been attack-minded. However, this Cardinal defense has held her to just 2 points. Hole driving baseline, and Bad Bear may have deflected that shot. And so trying to create a little juice for her group on the offensive end via some good defense. Stolen away. Darian White, the team's leading scorer, launches this one and well off the mark. We talked about the Stanford team coming in on a 20-game winning streak, second longest active win streak in the nation behind Jackson State. Think about the way they were able to pick up some big wins over Arizona, Tennessee, Oregon on the season. Just 3 losses on the year. Wilson.
Stanford, to me, just flying a little under the radar, right? I mean, they swept the Pac-12, handled their business. They haven't lost since December. And I think they're used to that. Nobody's really talking about us. Haley Jones, though, defensively swatting it. Oh, off her. Jones, how are you going to do her like that? That was not Cali Cool.
That was not Cali Cool. Just one person. But back to your point of, you know, the way that they have been able to register those 20 wins in a row is because of a great combination, and offensively, again, just so fluid on that end of the floor. It's pretty basketball to watch. I think kind of one of the conversations that, you know, we've had coming into the tournament is, who's the most dangerous team? Who don't you want to face at this point in the year? The three losses for Stanford have been by 5 points or less, okay? Then you have Paige Beckers, who's returned to the UConn lineup, and Gina Auriemma said, no, you don't want to see us. We're really dangerous right now. South Carolina, number one overall seed. Caitlin Clark in Iowa. And right now, nobody wants to see Hannah Jump from three-point land, because right now, Jump with four triples in the ballgame.
Just putting on a shooting clinic in this game. Just spotting up, ready to shoot on the catch. Part of that funky four. Recruiting class, Prechtel Jump, Haley Jones, and Fran Belibi. Their words, not mine. Let me clarify.
I was going to ask you about the, oh, partner, you came up with the funky four?
I wish. You know, the Stanford players, they're way, way smarter than me. Come on.
Yeah, and they're feeling really good right now because they just finished up finals. And so when we saw them in their practice yesterday, I mean, Tara Vanderveer was like, oh, man, they're just loosey-goosey right now. I think they're a little out of it because they have been locked in. So
she said silly.
Okay.
They look silly. But fun. They were having fun, and I think that's one thing that Tara Vanderveer really preaches to the team.
Hall going up to get that rebound. With a foul called against Stanford, going against, or rather going against Montana, Taylor Jansen. And Lexi Hall gets a big ovation. Jump going for it again. This one rolls around.
Jump just picking the zone apart. Not even fair at this point. Finding the gaps. Just hunting shots.
And stolen away by Hall, running on the break. Hall swings it over to Jump. And then poked away, the active hands on defense from the Bobcats.
All Stanford here in this third quarter. Hannah Jump lighting it up from Palo Alto. Heat check.
Fourth, UT Arlington was up 6 at the half. We'll keep you updated. This is a good one, Tiffany and Steffi.
Indeed, thanks so much. Well, Ashley Jones, the Iowa State career leading scorer, doing her thing, but that's going to be an interesting one, too.
I call Greensboro the record breakers region. You got Aaliyah Boston, what she's been able to do, breaking Sylvia Fowles' record in the SEC and double doubles earlier, and Caitlin Clark. Just special.
Special individual, yes.
An unassuming player, but what she's able to do is just has been unbelievable with the opportunity to be able to be the first female to lead the country in assists and scoring.
That one rolling around for Taylor Jansen.
But we heard the crew talking at the half. Mm. It's a close one right now with UT Arlington
yes.
and Iowa State. Mm-hmm. Sharika Wright on the sideline. She was on Christy Curry's side. She can coach. She has got her team in the hunt.
Just curious, who do you have winning National Player of the Year?
Ooh.
Aaliyah Boston.
Aaliyah Boston yeah. or Caitlin Clark, okay.
Aaliyah Boston.
That's been one of the fun conversations throughout the season, and especially toward the latter part. Both dynamic basketball players, both great for the game of basketball.
No question. I mean, the way they both play, they're very special. And I think what Aaliyah Boston has been able to do on the best team all year long, her consistency on both ends of the floor. But I think for Caitlin Clark, what really catches everybody's eye is just like the same thing with Steph Curry when he was playing is he was a scrawny little guy out there just balling on everybody. And that's what Caitlin Clark does. And for the average viewer at home, they're like, wow. You know, like, unbelievable that she can shoot from basically half court and right. not miss a beat. It's just something you don't necessarily see a lot of the time. So, you know, both of their ability to dominate, they've made a strong case for player of the year, National Player of the Year.
Well, when you look at Caitlin Clark's numbers, I think what is equally as impressive as, yes, she had 27 points today, but again, going back to her facilitating, using and utilizing the weapons around her to register 10 assists.
Yeah, I heard Rebecca Lobo talking about it in the studio, just how she knows when to score, knows when to facilitate, so everyone's not standing around watching her. Mm-hmm. And I think that's been the key for Iowa to become a hot team into this tournament.
Spin move, the left hand just short, and Belibi with the rebound. Some new faces on the court with the Stanford Cardinal, Belibi, Prechtel, jump, but also the grad transfer Jordan Hamilton and Agnes Imanopu.
Darian White and Cola Madden in for the Bobcats.
There's the starting five. Likely will have their evening complete. Bad Bear, a little Native American on the team of the Crow Tribe. Got a wonderful support system back at home, as we learned the Native Americans, the largest minority in Bozeman. And that one stripped away. Bobcats find it. But Darian Wilson can't finish. Lexi Deedon keeping it alive. Stepping through a couple of defenders, and Cola Bad Bear is fouled. And a great send-off for Cola Bad Bear and the Montana State Bobcats on the front steps of the Rick Breeden Fieldhouse in Bozeman, Montana. And the song in the native tongue being sung implores them to take courage and have a warrior spirit. Talking about also, you know, friends and relatives that were behind them. And a great appreciation.
Yeah, I mean, really cool story reading about Cola Bad Bear and just her life and making her way to Montana State and growing up. Just the evolution as a young lady and as a player. Trisha Benford sings her praises all day long.
As the fifth-year senior Jordan Hamilton gets on the board. You just think about that transition you make. She grew up on the reservation and then moves for more opportunity to the city of Bozeman just before the start of high school. And it was beneficial for her and her siblings. As the Bobcats need to get a shot up before the shot clock expires. And it does.
The Cardinal holding Montana State to just 17% shooting from the floor today.
Beliebe. Over to Jana Van Guytenbeek. And just left short, Beliebe there on the offensive rebound. Get another try at it, and she's fouled.
Second personal, number 15, Leah Beattie.
The back-to-back Pac-12 champions in complete control in this one. We mentioned their perfect season during league play, the eighth in program history. Will the NCAA men's basketball championship? First round continues on CBS, TBS, TNT, and True TV. For more information on tournament game times and listings, go to NCAA.com. About the luck of the Irish coming in to play, and Montana State also was in the first round. They didn't have the showing they would have liked, however, I'll say this much, that the president and athletic director went from San Diego, flew up the coast of California to be here tonight for the Bobcats game against Stanford.
The town is buzzing, basically.
Yes. I
mean, not the outcome the men's team wanted.
Can they get a shot up before the end of the quarter? Darian Wilson's shot just off the mark. Stanford with a big cushion as we step aside after three. Steffi Sorensen, Tiffany Green with you from Maples Pavilion. The top seed Stanford Cardinal with a sizable lead over Montana State. Let's take a look at tonight's Capital One rewarding performance.
Fran Beliebe, 12 points, 13 rebounds. This slam-a-jamma, putting it down here at Maples Pavilion. Had the whole arena rocking. And the fans loved it. The bench brought back to life.
I love the fan.
The fan, the fan was
my
favorite.
Oh, my goodness. I could play that over and over and laugh each time in watching it. Ms. Beliebe with her second double-double of the season. And she's all smiles. The defending national champs, the number one seed for the second straight year. Talked about just how well they played down the stretch, winners of 20 straight. The depth that they pose. The offense and defense, a finely tuned instrument. And Kiki Iriafin is one of those players of the future for the Stanford Cardinal. High praise for the true freshman out of Los Angeles.
And the ninth different player for Stanford to score. I mean, they have got a ton of depth. And Tara Vandeveer can let her reserves, or excuse me, her starters rest.
a well-earned breather and break for the rest of the game for Stanford Cardinal starters who came out in the opening quarter and just did not look back. They were firing on all cylinders. And Brooke Dimitri is now the 10th Cardinal to get in the scoring column. And it's worth repeating that certainly everyone, no matter where you're playing, even Gabby Maki, happened to be playing in a tournament. It's the first time since 2017 for Montana State, but to have fans back in the building. 2020, COVID canceled it. And then last year, from a neutral site in Texas, or several neutral sites in Texas. That one rolls around for Van Gatenbeek. So this is what you want to hear.
And remember, the at Stanford team played away from their home arena. They lived out of suitcases for weeks on end. I mean, it was a difficult season for them. So you can feel that this atmosphere, they're really relishing in it right now.
How incredible was it that this group was on the road and away for 65 days from their home arena. Won 13 games on the road. Had a really great run to the Final Four. Tough matchup with South Carolina. Able to squeak by in that one and did the same against Arizona in the national championship to get the third in program history.
You know, the mental toughness that it took to do that. Basically, you played, you ate, you slept. That was it. No contact with anybody. I mean, they really kept their bubble tight. I think recovering from that, just being around people, and I think the team just grew so close.
Melissa Jerome off the mark there. Keeping it normal, or as normal as possible, in a situation like that, you also have to credit Tara Vanderveer and her staff. They've seen a lot of things. She told us that just before the game. I've seen a little bit, just about everything.
First team foul.
Obviously, that was a new experience for everyone. But always finding ways to motivate her team, or keep our group focused, or have fun in learning through the process. And the Hall of Fame coach who has had amazing success. It's just one of the fun people. We've enjoyed even just talking to her. What did you call her? The social butterfly?
Social butterfly. Talking to all the coaches. Came over, popped over at halftime, talked to us a little bit. Mentioned how grateful she is to have this job. She's the luckiest coach in the world. I will say, it is very beautiful out here.
Yes, it is.
That's Florida people coming in here.
But when you look at coaches, you kind of think of, okay, well, what's the right fit? And when you think of Tara Vanderveer in Stanford, it's just like that perfect puzzle piece connecting with the next.
I'm going to go really weird pop culture. Fun fact for you.
Hit me.
Davidson dating Kim Kardashian. He didn't just get a tattoo for Kim. He got her name branded on him. It's safe to say if Tara could have a brand, it's the Cardinal logo.
He worked Pete Davidson and Kim K into a conversation. Well done. Well done,
partner.
I'll
be here all day.
And on that note, we'll step aside with 5:55 remaining in this one. Taking a look at the Spokane region, and partner, is the left coast the best coast?
I'm just wondering, is the West Coast the best coast? You got the defending champions, Stanford out here, five conference players of the year. And then how about the coaching royalty?
Oh my goodness.
Kim Mulkey, Tar Vanderveer, Brenda Fries, Vic Schaefer, all in the Spokane region.
And all national championship coaches.
The Hull sisters from Stanford, from Spokane, they want to win the to get to their hometown.
And we talked about how special that would be for them to be able to play in front of their family, much like Kiana Williams got to do in last year's tournament in San Antonio. Hamilton with the mid-range, just past that free throw line, and Jordan Hamilton, who hails from the Lone Star State.
Tara Vanderveer telling us she's just such a great kid, cultured kid, came in, unselfish, loved by her teammates. She's always dancing too. I watch a lot of vlogging by Haley Jones and Fran Belibi. Those two, you gotta watch, it's fun.
And that's been the key, right? Tara Vanderveer said, we want to have fun. And certainly, the Stanford Cardinal has had plenty of fun thus far. The NCAA Women's Championship is presented by Capital One. What's in your wallet?
Kelsey, Drea, and Monica with you in the studio. We've got an update for you because Iowa State and UT Arlington are in a battle.
It has been a back and forth affair.
Thanks so much, and obviously we'll be keeping an eye on that game. Likely to have a great finish as we've seen some others come down to the wire. How about that game with Kansas, Georgia Tech earlier? It was the Jayhawks who came out looking good.
Coach Brandon had them ready to roll.
Yeah.
All business after the game. But listen, everyone in that Greensboro region was kind of talking about Iowa, Iowa State, mm-hmm. potentially Iowa, South Carolina. Iowa State not out of the hunt with UT Arlington now.
Is it slow your roll?
Yes.
Okay. And Stanford just over 3 minutes away from moving on to the second round. So when you think about that matchup against the Jayhawks out of the Big 12, you know, what can viewers anticipate tomorrow Sunday?
Well, the thing for Kansas is that, you know, they can defend. They've got size. They've got speed along the perimeter. I think the biggest thing is their ability to score against Stanford. Consistency, consistently, and not having any kind of scoring lulls. We saw that against Georgia Tech. But it's definitely intriguing. I mean, we've got some talent. You know, Holly Hurskeeter was terrific. Tyana Jackson, 6'6". You know, Montana State just didn't have the size and the athleticism to keep up with Stanford. But Kansas, very competitive out of the Big 12. I'm excited for watching practices and watching both teams get ready for the next round.
Ashley Van Sickle, one of the two seniors on this team for Montana State. And pushing it back the way, other way, Jordan Hamilton. And then the traveling violation.
The thing that's important to point out is Montana State, the players that took the floor today, they will never forget this moment, ever. It's very few people get to make it to this opportunity at the NCAA tournament. Maples Pavilion, the number one seed, Stanford. And you get threes like that 10 years from now, you think about this moment. You know, that's what it's all about. I'm saying this because my junior year, I went and we got blown out by UConn, but it's still my favorite memory of basketball.
Yeah, and I like
little plays. It's like, oh man, that was so much fun. You'll never get that back.
I love what you said just about you.
We got blown out?
No, no, not the point that you got blown out, but the fact that you really enjoyed it as Van Sickle gets on the board. That's her first two. We mentioned one of the two seniors, but how you just relished in the moment and not really cowering to UConn, right, but instead really appreciating for where you were and enjoying the moment. Final minute of this one. And rebounded by Lexi Deedon. And the sharpshooter sitting next to me is like, oh, baby, you got to shoot that. Come
Let
on.
Let it rip.
Yeah.
Let it rip. Hamilton with the D.
And it can be tough coming in knowing that you're outmatched. But what I loved in watching this Bobcats team is they didn't back down, nor did they stop fighting.
That's right. And you expect that from a Trisha Benford team and the way that she carries herself and her teams. They embody her personality. She knew Stanford was good. She didn't shy away about telling us that.
And the folks in Bozeman have to be proud of their team making it here, but a standing ovation inside Maples Pavilion as Stanford routs the Bobcats and moves on to the second round, winners of now 21 in a row. And a quick update to the bracket as Sunday's second round matchup is set as the top seed Cardinal will face off against the 8 seed Jayhawks, along with Florida Gulf Coast and Maryland. Should be some really interesting matchups come Sunday. Well, Stanford, a wholesale effort. They used all 15 players as Lexi Hull at 13, Hannah Jump, who kept knocking down threes left and right, finished with 15 points overall, 5 from long distance to register all of her points. And of course, Fran Belibi, who impressed all inside the arena at 12 points and 13 boards. She's celebrating at half court with her teammates.
Taking this up, this one in.
Yeah. Russell Wilson, he's an onlooker. He's a fan cheering on his sister. Proud of the Cardinal effort here tonight. And wow. Stanford rolls on to yet another win. And we are awaiting Fran Belibi, who made the play of the tournament thus far, to join us. And I'm being told, yes, she's with us. And Fran, okay, you know, everybody is going to give yeah. you like plenty house about that dunk. Take us back to the block and the flush.
Yeah, I mean, we're just trying to play good defense. I know that their team has some shooters, some post-hoop shooters, so I was just trying to recover back, and I ended up getting the block, and I was kind of checking to see if she was there, and she slowed down, I think. I don't know, but I went for it, and it went in.
What was going through your head in the fast break, the decision maybe to lay it up versus the way that you threw it down?
Well, I mean, my teammates have been getting on me because I haven't dunked yet this year. And so I kind of saw the opportunity and decided I might as well try. We got a full house here in Maples, and it's my first time in Maples playing not only a final, or not a Final Four game, but a tournament game, and my first time dunking here at Maples in a game, so I figured I might as well try it out.
Well, you talked about Final Four. You got to speak that into existence, but Fran, just in terms of being able to play in front of fans, how did that get you extra juiced up tonight?
Yeah, I mean, we love it here at Maples, and it's crazy that as a junior, this is my first time playing a tournament game at Maples. And so we were all really excited, all of us juniors, the sophomores, and I know all the upperclassmen, we're all super excited to be able to have a chance to keep playing here at Maples and get another chance on Sunday to do it. So it was for sure really dope to have fans here, and I hope they liked it.
All right, well, you're really dope, too. Thanks for that, Duncan.
Right.
The best player of the tournament thus far. Enjoy the win.
Thank you so much.
Well, Steffi, what a great win for the Stanford Cardinal. And they will celebrate this victory and await Sunday's game. And again, once more, be excited about those fans being in the stands. And this is what got everybody standing up and pumped up inside of Maples Pavilion for Steffi Sorensen. I'm Tip the Green saying so long from Palo Alto. Let's send it back to the studio.